Hello again, everybody. It is the coach.
Coach, thank you much. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. Today, it's an NFC West battle between the San Francisco 49ers and the Los Angeles Rams. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down. Breida, CD, an undrafted free agent from a season ago, and with McKinnon out, he's really helped fill the running void for the 49ers.
Yeah, remember, they got Jerick McKinnon as a free agent and expect him to be a three-down back for them. As you mentioned, out for the season with an ACL injury. Almost fitting that Matt Breida stepped into the breach for him. They were college teammates at Georgia Southern. Breida leading the league in rushing, tied for the lead, I should say, through the first 3 weeks of the season. And don't forget, in reserve, Kyle Juszczyk, their fullback, who can take some plays at running back as well.
Green 39! Green 39!
Right back to him on first down. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Pickup of 28 yards.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
Yeah, that was a good start getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
They'll drop the throw. Almost able to intercept it. That's one he would have liked to have held on to on this first drive. Instead, 2nd down.
I know in every game we do, we talk about momentum. That was a momentum play lost. And now there could be a letdown because they didn't get the interception.
Yeah, you could almost hear the collective gasp on the sideline as he could not come up with that football. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that opened things up for you on the outside as well.
But that's where he, their big tight end, is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the end routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well, and he's got it.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. Robbie Gould on now to try the field goal. And Gould is able to put it through. And the 49ers take a 3-0 lead. So a nice drive on the road. You come in, you take the ball down, you get 3 points.
Yeah, points are a must on an opening drive, right? So they moved it down efficiently, got it done. I think that bodes well for their chances moving forward in this one.
The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. It's a short kick, taking it to 15. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Goff will lead the Rams up here, first and 10 at the 33-yard line. A play fake to Gurley. Now Goff. He finds a man with a crossing route. And now to cross midfield down to the 45. A good pickup there of 22.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. They go play action here on first down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Trying to get it to Woods, and now it's second down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, you give yourself your best chance.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace. I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
And that is incomplete.
Well, touch and time are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
On now is the big leg of Greg Zuerlein. He has hit from as far as 61 away in his career. They spot it on the midfield stripe, so it is a 60-yard attempt here. And he missed it. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
The 49er offense, they're coming back out onto the field, and we're going to give you a look at the playoff picture now into the weekend in the NFC. And it's all come down to this, hasn't it? Final week of the regular season. As this year's playoffs play out anything like the regular season has gone, could be in for a wild and fun month of January.
And we can break the rules because we can look ahead. All right, there's not a coach out there that's ever said to their team, all right, let's look three weeks down the road. It's always right here, right now. Forget that. Think about what the playoffs are going to look like. The teams that we see that are already in, the teams that are trying to get in, we could have some great matchups.
These are his numbers from last week's contest. 7 catches, 74 yards.
And most teams mark down big plays as ones that gain 10 yards or more. He certainly has big playability, and we just saw it on display.
They run with Breida, and he'll snag about 5 yards down to the 32.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
They're going to look to throw over the middle, and he's got Goodwin complete. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
They'll look to throw now on first down. The throw left side caught by Goodwin. And down inside the 15 he goes. 11 yards for number 11. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out.
Here we go now, 3-19.
He'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down. So we'll look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stopped your team just the way you're supposed to.
This will be caught at about the 6. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
So scores on their first two possessions, but 6-0, so field goal is probably not what they were hoping for.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
Well, the Los Angeles Rams, not yet owners of a first-round bye. They have clinched the NFC West, first in the NFL to win their division. But last week, surprisingly, only put up 6 points in that loss in Chicago.
Not surprising overall in terms of defensive struggle, because you had the last two defensive players of the year in the NFL playing in that game, Aaron Donald for the Rams and Khalil Mack for the Bears, and the Bears have been strong on D all year long. What I found interesting was how the Bears scored their touchdown. Right? Trick play, backup offensive tackle, catches a touchdown pass. How often do you see that?
Not very often. By the way, going to make a big difference whether the Rams play in 70-degree L.A. or 20-degree Chicago. A little bit different for the weather style.
It certainly is, which means that down the stretch, the Rams still have to play excellent football. Just because they won the division, they can't kick back. They need to lock up one of those two home field byes to start the playoffs.
Now on second down, this is Gurley. And a nice run past the 30-yard line there. 9 good yards here on the run, and now third down.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
Goff now looking to throw.
going to be incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
This is taken around the 12. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. The 49er offense, they're coming back out onto the field, and we're going to give you a look at the playoff picture now into the weekend in the NFC. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll make it second down.
It's funny, throughout the time that we've been together, when we talk with running backs about the ability to catch the ball, their eyes light up when they talk about open field and having one-on-one matchups, don't they?
Yeah, they do. That's the reason why. What we just saw, shedding those tackles, and that's what they're used to doing.
It is, and it starts at the beginning of the play, one-on-one matchup with someone trying to cover them, but they also like those one-on-ones downfield after the catch when they're running with the ball. They think they're going to win those, too.
He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. I think you mentioned in the opening drive that these guys needed to establish the run, protect the young QB. Actually broke that down, believe it or not. So how would you assess things so far?
I'm kind of touched that you actually wrote something like that down. I appreciate that, partner. But I do think they've been able to do that. Maybe not as effectively as they wanted to, but I think we'll see more as this game goes along, because they want to continue to take care of that young QB.
A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4.
Not the result they were looking for there on third down. They end up taking a loss on the play. The only person happy now, the punter, gets to go out there and show mom that he gets to play in the game.
2 minutes remain here in the first half. We're back to the City of Angels after this timeout. And we remind you, coming up at the half, we'll join who, Charles?
The coach.
The coach, Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from games in progress, as well as scores from earlier today.
Sorry,
we get slap happy up here sometimes. And the Rams getting set to go now. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. Now a first down throw, gone. Over the middle, complete. That's Reynolds. And he's able to get up here to the 26. A gain of 6 there on first. Clock continuing to roll as the Rams try to get going again. Now gone. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. A really nice gain of 25 yards. First down now, but that clock rolling. Goff on first down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. He's been good. His guys are winning. So far, the recipe working here in the second quarter.
And he doesn't like to just tote the rock. He wants to carry his team on his back. And that's what he's done throughout this game.
Yeah, he's done that. He'll be hoping to continue that trend. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
All right, now look at 56.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And down he goes on the pressure from the Rams defense. And Ndamukong Suh in there to drop him for his 5th sack of the year. And they weren't in zone coverage, they were in man. And each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a defensive player of the year at the other. And they just locked people down.
Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Goodwin. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. They get 11 back on that one and reach to third down.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
The Niners on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 7. Back to throw. But able to haul it in is Kittle. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. George Kittle, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the 49ers add 6 to their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Robbie Gould on for the extra point. Gold able to tack on the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Scoring summary, 3-play drive, and the end result for the 49ers, a touchdown. The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. As the Rams offense comes back out, here is the NFC playoff picture coming into the weekend. And right now, a lot to like on that screen. They've wrapped up the division, now currently sitting in the coveted number 2 spot. Of course, you want one. You'd love number 1, but if you can't have one, number 2 is pretty good.
I agree with you totally, and here's the other part, too. The really good teams, the really confident teams, they're not as worried about being number 1. 2 is fine because they feel like they can go on the road and win against number 1 if they absolutely have to. The big thing, though, is clinching one of those early byes and able to sit and get a little rest as the playoffs begin.
The last play got just a yard. Here's 2nd and 9 from the 26. So we've come upon halftime here in week 17 as we'll send you eastward to Orlando. Standing by with the Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coach with Taylor Coach. All right, great to thank you as always. Welcome to our final Sports regular season edition of our halftime report. Playoff lines pending and the balance as we take you around the NFL one final time. Beginning in the NFC West, Arizona heading up north to take on Seattle.
yards away from halftime, all tied in that one.
The final two quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the second half of Week 17 is underway. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Rams offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Here's a second and two now from the 33. That's awful. Hand this one to Gurley. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is well into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 33, and his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, I think you can take the spirit away from another team. That their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
It's still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they? For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. A solid pickup at 13 sets him up first and goal.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Three red zone trips have yielded just two field goals for them to this point, so they'll be searching for something more on second and goal here.
Hurry up, here we go.
Now it's Breida. Oh, now he bowls him over. So he got three of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. A pickup of four on first down, it'll be second and goal.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Second and goal from the one. Going to get it running right, and he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. A great play there with his first career NFL touchdown, and the Niners take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in.
Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, the second half, no matter what, whether it's first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
And now this is right in Kyle Shanahan's wheelhouse. He'll go for two here. Here's a toss coming right, and he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more. The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Solomon Thomas there on the tackle.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
On second down, here's Goff. He's got his man on the crossing route. And they're able to get this one across the 35. First down, L.A., Goff finding Higbee.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
Nothing in that first half, nothing on the last drive, but they're moving now with a first and 10. On first down, it's Gurley. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
But if these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they're going to have to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage will be found.
Another carry now for Gurley. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain that time, but it leaves him with third and 11 coming up.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Throwing on third, gone. Get there and bring him down. Solomon Thomas able to get outside the numbers and drop him for a loss of a yard.
Looks like another empty possession here, partner, and I don't think with three scores down in the third quarter they can truly afford any more the rest of the way.
No, especially the way their offense is sputtering. I think you're exactly right. They got to find some answers quickly.
Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And And San Francisco gets set to go here. They had the double-digit lead at halftime, and they have continued to roll. They're hard to stop right now.
I think what we're seeing is an example of a team that has it figured out in this ballgame. And whatever the adjustments are the defense has made, hasn't fazed them at all. They either anticipated them, or they've been so far ahead that they just can't catch up.
Now it's just a search to add to the lead. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he will fight his way forward to about the 23-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
A good solid game there on first down, but the defense has to be happy. They didn't let it pop for anything bigger.
One quarter remains here as the regular season starts to wind down. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Los Angeles. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. Now second and seven from the 23. Here's Breida. And he'll take it forward for about five up to the 28-yard line.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
The Niners on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. Here it's third and two. They run again with Breida, and he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
I haven't met a football team yet that runs the ball successfully that doesn't talk about having an attitude to be a running football team, right? You got to be able to put your nose in there, smell where the first down sticks are, and get there.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Now let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
Now it's the Florida Atlantic alum. This is Alfred Morris. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. This is Breida. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
Runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10.
All right, now look at 56.
Right back to him on first down. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. On the stop was Aaron Donald. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep them to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
Hurry up, here we go.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Hurry up, here we go.
Now it's Morris. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
They're in a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves, start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. Stay on the ground. Again, it's Breida. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. They only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
I've got an idea. Let's skip racing to the airport at the end of this game. Let's go to the post-game press conference. I have a feeling that the quarterback of this winning team is going to be giving a whole lot of credit to the running game and the offensive line.
Yeah, I was just going to say the offensive line, yes, carrying the ball has been key, but those guys up front, they've made a lot of space. They've gone to the 4th up in Seattle. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Josh Rosen, outstanding to this point, 4 touchdown passes. All runs on this drive so far. It's 1st and 10. Go on the ground. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because really they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
The storyline of this one, Charles, no doubt the number 0, zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is, and what an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team. There's a lot of pride that goes into shutting out an opponent. And how about that 0 on the scoreboard for them, going along with those 0s in the time column, too?
So for the Niners, they do finish things out with a victory here in the final week, but the victories were few and far between as they'll end the year 5-11. And by just about all accounts, not the type of year they were hoping to have. Meanwhile, for L.A., this was basically just an exhibition game for them as they'd already clinched home field advantage. But more importantly, they'll get a week to rest as they've earned a first-round bye in this year's playoffs.